evening. Y'all ready for some crazy taxi? No, wait, wrong game. It's time for more Endless Ocean. I hope everybody had a great day. I'm sorry I didn't stream yesterday. I had to work. I worked until 12:30, which is past the normal time that I stream. So, priorities to be adjusted. I'm back. And, Saturday, we healed some fishies. I tried to sound like Jacques Cousteau. I am not a very good Jacques Cousteau. I apologize. But we're gonna jump into it here. Got Endless Ocean already queued up. And, yeah. After I switch scenes, I'll post in different areas of, hey, let's dive in. Let's have some fun today. We're gonna go to the Aegean Sea. We're gonna look for Valka Castle. And just have a sort of peaceful time in the water. Unlike the last time when we played the lovely Shamu's Deep Sea Adventure. So, onward to Endless Ocean, Blue World. Now, one of the issues that I am having is that there's a cat on my desk already. Hopefully he doesn't knock over the sensor bar, but if I have to abruptly pause, that's why. And I'll probably explain it again for any stragglers. Okay. Make sure I got my little wrist doodle. Ah, the cat's already staring at me like, what are you doing? Fantastic. Whoops. Hey. That over. So. We are here. Oh, he's already getting up. Okay, hold on. Oh. Just use the handy dandy D-pad. Let's read the notebook. This cat is kind of being a little sketchy. Like, I'm saying that because he looks like he's deciding wants to do. Is he gonna be a toot, or is he gonna work with me here? Oh, he's already trying to push a keyboard. Oh. Hey, no, he can't push the keyboard. We don't need any of these, so let's charter a plane and head to Cicero or something. Cicero's great in the Aegean Sea. Okay. Sure. Why not? Let's go to a strait. This channel runs between outlying islands of the Cyclades group in the Aegean Sea. Its varied terrain and shark-infested waters make it popular divers. Its array of sunken wrecks also make it a prime destination for treasure-hunting salvagers. Ooh. This area is called Cicero Strait. It's known for its reefs and is said to be the resting place of Valka Castle. Why did my dad send us here? I cannot begin to guess. Well, if we can find Valka Castle, we should discover something. How are we going to search for it? Using a grid pattern? No, I'm going to swim in circles until we find it. Duh. I have something in mind for that. What? Okay. Nice. Wow. I recently visited a friend in Italy, an old diving contact. I was able to get my hands on something very useful. Ahoy there! Hey, B. What was that? Hello, can you hear me? What are you doing here? You scared me half to death. How are you, B? Well, well, you must be a boatload of newcomers. Mind if I come aboard? Sure, it's nice to be out of the water for a bit. Nice dinghy you got here. Sure. You guys have any bubble tea or energy drinks? This is thirsty work. I'm good. Yeah. If you're out in the water and stuff, I think you probably just want to drink regular water and not like sugary drinks. But what do I know? She's gonna say, we have water, orange juice, and soda. Who are you anyway? Don't you recognize me? I'm Gaston Gray. You call me Gigi. Rolls off the tongue, doesn't it? Gigi, I've heard of that name. You're that famous American salvager. Right you are. Check out B's channel. She streams. And last played at Dauntless. Right you are. I've been here the past few months in pursuit of an old dream. I'm searching for the treasure from the legendary Valka Castle. What? Really? That's why we're here too. Seriously? Waters around here aren't for beginners, you know. This area has been notorious for shipwrecks since the day of ancient Greeks. There are restless, relentless, giant whirlpools, reefs crawling with sharks, not to mention one infamous shark who pretty much owns this place. Nice. The giant man-eater, Thanatos. Okay. Ever heard of him? This is his territory. He'll swallow you up in one bite. My point is, it seems pretty likely who's going to find the castle first and claim all that treasure. The world-famous Gigi. Of course. Yeah, let us know what you find there, bud. What are you saying? We're pro divers. Let's show this windbag what LL Diving Service can do. I feel like Gigi is gonna double cross him at some point in time. I don't think he will, because it's not this kind of game, but you can talk all you like. There's no way you're better than me. You just chill, Cat. Now I can't read what he says. You don't blame me? Fine. Are you willing to bet on which of us will find Valka Castle first? Oh. You're out of it. Oh, you're on. If you find it before me, I'll scrub your boat with my toothbrush. Just don't cry when I find it first. See you around. Well, he's a little cocky guy, isn't he? That guy was so annoying. And rude, too. Sweet wetsuit, though. Yep. There's a lot of dialogue in this game compared to what we've been playing. That's fine. Text, I mean. Not dialogue. Well, I mean, it is dialogue, but it's in text form, so I get to read it. Well, so much for taking your time on this mission. Grandpa, you were in the middle of saying something. What was it? Yes. Have a look at this. A multi-sensor. It's the latest electromagnetic multi-sensing device. That's multi-sensor for short. It's used for searching underwater. It should help us find what we're looking for much more efficiently. Awesome. We'll find Valka Castle in no time with this. Unfortunately, its range is about 100 feet. We need to find some clues about the castle's whereabouts first. Just think about it. No one has ever found the place. Valka Castle isn't going to be just lying around somewhere on the seafloor. But it's an entire castle. It can't be that hard to find. As usual, I'll leave the gadgets to you. From how you've handled the Pulsar, I'm sure you'll have no trouble with this. When you're ready, start your dive, and I'll show you how to use the multi-sensor. My goodness. Cat. You are an annoying cat, but that's fine. Now we have to actually press A on that one, huh? So I guess with it being a straight, we're kind of more confined areas. That's fine. Those are sharks. See, the fun thing about this is the cat's not blocking the IR sensor, he's just blocking the monitor. So I can see it. It's a row straight. There's some hammerhead sharks. Can you hear me? It's John Eric. The multi-sensor is used to find objects buried in the seabed. Ship's sonar indicates that it's too deep here to use it. Should be an opening between the rocks right in front of you. Try moving over there first. Okay, we gotta hurry, because we got, X amount of air. Ooh, a line surgeon fish. North Canyon, Cicero's Strait. This area should do nicely. What? There's a lot of sharks? Don't be scared. Those are just hammerhead sharks. They can be a little unpredictable. There are almost no reports of attack. as long as you don't startle them. Hey, last one. You should have nothing to worry about. How are you, last one? Go ahead and equip the multi-sensor. The multi-sensor works similarly to organs in the head of hammerhead sharks, known as ampullae of Lorenzini, which help them find their prey. When you have it equipped, it will send out special electromagnetic waves that detect any unusual objects buried in the seabed. It also analyzes the material of objects the object is made of, as one or more of these types: stone, metal, wood, or high density. Ooh. Multi-sensor has picked up something. I am sorry to hear that you're in pain, man. We're doing good. Stone, high density. Must be a high density mineral of some kind. It's not detecting any metal or wood here. Pretty amazing technology, huh? My kids had an actual snow day. Because we got like 3 inches of snow yesterday. Or Sunday. So, they're super excited with it being close to Christmas. See the way the wave is fluctuating? The object must be right in front of you. Have a close look at the seafloor there. Oh, hey, we got a lapis lazuli chip. Looks like you found something. A piece of lapis lazuli? That pendant is made of lapis lazuli, too. Indeed it is. I wonder if there's some connection. From what I can see on the ship's sensor, there's a similar shallow region in the southwest. Why don't you search it with the multi-sensor? Okay. First, what are these fish? Are they tangs? No. They are sea goldies. And these fish? Shallowtail sea perch. Okay. Well, I don't really want to get too close to them, but, we gotta add these guys. And those are not hammerheads. Oh, I guess they are. They look like hammerheads. Can you hear me? It's Sean Eric. That big shark is a hammerhead. You can see that its T-shaped head looks a bit like the head of a hammer. These sharks are very popular with divers. When looking up from underneath, the hammerhead's silhouette can look quite surreal. It truly feels like you've entered another world. Scalloped hammerhead. Okay, so, yeah, we usually get like ice and stuff out here, so actually getting big flakes of snow that packed nicely was a change for them, because it's been a long time since we've gotten that. Ooh, jellyfish. And, yeah, just living the dream here. Moon jellyfish. Oh, what are these? Japanese jack mackerel. Man, there's so many fish there. Uh-oh. Alright, you're in the right place. Use the multi-sensor to search. There is a whirlpool right there. The multi-sensor is picking up something, but we're blocked by a whirlpool. This whirlpool must be one of the infamous Cicero's Undines. The ferry is known for these whirlpools. Sailors have feared them for generations. You'll have to try to get around it somehow. The map shows a rock face to your right. If you go back around it and then left, you should be able to get through. If you get confused, use 1 to check your map. Okay, man. We'll be here. Well, since we're over here, we might as well get this piece of the map done. Some sea perches. Some oriental butterfly fish. Let's move on. We don't have that much oxygen. Do not hit the shark. They will not like that. Oh man. Red sea bream. What on earth are these? Pelagic pressure shark? I'm not getting like a warning thing, but those look pretty cool. Their tails look really neat. That's a giant catfish. Oh, it's a sturgeon, not a catfish. That's a great sturgeon. Okay, we can't spend too much time looking at fish because we only have X amount of oxygen. There's a ship. What's left of a ship? Okay, here we go. Oh, look at that. We're like right above it. Okay. There it is. I bet it's another lapis. Yep. A lapis lazuli lump. Hey, it looks like you found something. What is it? Another piece of lapis lazuli. There seems to be quite a lot of it down there. In fact, there's too much of it to be naturally occurring naturally. Perhaps a ship carrying a load of these stones sank here and they spilled out. Hold on a second. I have some records here that might have that information. Ah, yes. It seems a ship called the Arctos went down near here. She sank in the early 20th century, and her wreck is still down here. There. She was a trader running between Egypt and Greece. You know, Egypt has been famous for its lapis lazuli crafts for centuries. The wrecks of Arctos, somewhere in E4 on your map. It might be worth searching for. Now that you know rough topography of this area, you can dive right from here next time. That's swell, dude. Thanks, Jean-Eric. Because what we have to do is we have to go... Oh, well, look at that thing. A common octopus. Nice. Oh, I'm hearing Silent Hill type noises. Wait, is that also a common octopus? It is. Ooh. Look, an Indo-Pacific sailfish. It has such a beautiful dorsal fin. It's totally unique. They usually fold up their dorsal fins when swimming to reduce water resistance. Unfortunately, that means we don't get to see them very often. I think sailfish are super cool, don't you? The one thing I forgot yesterday that kind of plays a big role in here is that you have to be mindful of your oxygen. And apparently, looking at fish and reading about them, well, I think that's actually done during your playtime, so... Those are some big fish. Atlantic bluefin tuna. Uh-oh. Oh no, look over there. It's a great white shark. Great white sharks are just as ferocious as tiger sharks. This one seems really mad for some reason. Can you use the pulsar to calm it down? If you can take care of this guy for us, we can take our time searching the ship. Shoot. Where is he? Oh, shoot. Great white shark swam off. Great, now we can relax and get on with the search. Let's use the multi-sensor to see if there's anything in this area. Well, the thing is that I have to hurry because we don't have that much stuff left. Long-tailed grouper. You find a Triton bracelet. Wow, what's this? Looks like an old bracelet with something carved in on it. Hey look, isn't this the same? Some kind of map? It looks like a town surrounded by whirlpools, doesn't it? Whirlpools? Could that mean the Cicero's Undines? The Cicero Undines are found mainly in the waters to the southwest. Why don't you investigate that area? Yeah, we don't have much else in the way of leads. Why don't we take a look? Southwest of Cicero Strait. I mean, we can. European parrotfish. Mahi-mahis. At least I need things. Ooh, cloudy cat sharks. Cat sharks. Ooh, is that a sea cucumber? No, it is not. It's a striget Chromodorus. Okay. No, there's a thing over here. We have to resurface, fill up our air tanks. A Singapore prawn guppy, okay. And a goby. Say guppy, I meant goby. And a goby shrimp. They kind of work together. They have a symbiotic relationship, I think. Anything? The ship ambiance noise reminds me of noises from PT, which isn't very good. A white-tipped reef shark. Cicero's Undines are stopping us from going southwest. Can you hear me? It's Johnny. I took another look at my sea charts. Southwest Cicero Strait is completely sealed off by the five Cicero's Undines. There's no way to proceed. We're at a total emptiness. Oh, that's just great. What do we do now? I'm gonna show Nancy our find. Oh yeah, that's that lapis lazuli bracelet. it has some kind of ancient writing engraved on it. Maybe Nancy can tell us what it means. What should we do? Head back to Night Ball Island for now? I have 3 bars of oxygen. We definitely are heading back. We gotta find that castle though before Gigi finds it. Your diving level went up. If not really expanded in the map of the area yet. Some water. Do you know a lot of the ocean is still unexplored? Which is surprising because, you know, we have technology, but who knows? You know, sometimes I wish I could just send you stuff by email. Haha, what can I get for you? Got me to look at something for you. Showed Nancy the Triton bracelet. Ah, another old artifact. This is Lapis Lazuli, and it's very, very old. And carved on it, we have, wow, this is written in Linear B. Linear B is a script that was used by the Mycenaeans. Going with it. Who lived on the islands, the Aegean Sea. It's over 3,500 years, predating even the Greek alphabet. This is an extremely rare find. What's on it? Well, Linear B is a known alphabet, and the words themselves are Greek, so the internet should solve most of our problems. Just hold on there a minute. I've deciphered the text. Fishermen of Triton Village of the Iloris Cape. Pay heed if you value your life. Even the whirling waters hear the night. Sail when all is quiet in the calm twilight. This looks like some kind of warning written by ancient fishermen. Calm twilight must be at night after the sunset. Oh, that reminds me. Sean Eric, you asked me for some night diving gear. I have it for you right here. You've already paid me for it, so here we go. And here's a free gift. Consider it an apology for the long wait. An underwater pen. It works by suspending fluorescent dye in the water. Neat, isn't it? It's perfect for communicating in dark places. Oh, and if you find anything interesting with your multi-sensor, let me know. I'll appraise it for you, for a small fee, of course. Okay, I guess the coins that I got are meaningless. Nothing new. We don't care about that right now. Okay. Well, thanks, Nancy. Now that we have night diving gear, we can dive anytime we want. How about we head back to Cicero Strait? Do what the bracelet says. You do get situations where whirlpools appear and disappear over time. So it's fully believable that a whirlpool can disappear at night. Any new quests? Yep. Find the blue bird. There it is, I see it. Oh, Where are you standing? Oh, wow. That's a beautiful blue bird. You don't see many like that around here. I wonder where it came from. Hey, it's letting me walk right up to it. Is it a pet or something? Try giving it some food.
Follow me!
Aw, oh, it flew away. Did I just say something? No, I didn't say anything. You want to chase after that blue bird? It flew towards the common atoll. It's a reef, so there are plenty of small islands it can land on around there. If you want to find the bird, take a look for places it can land. Yeah. Okay, so... I guess we need to follow that bird. But not Big Bird, just that bird. Now, she said we had to take a plane to get to the Aegean Sea, but I think we still have the same boat. Might as well look at all the blue tanks. We might as well swim here so we can go north and get more of the map uncovered. Oh yes, I almost forgot. Hey, psyched. How are ya? How does metal detecting? This has kind of metal detecting. You can salvage your stuff. I can understand that. I was pretty busy yesterday myself. I stayed up until 12:30 working. Yeah, this game also has that. In fact, I have a multi-sensor here. Oh. So, we've just found something here. Look at that, we found a small jar. It's too big to fit in our bag. Well, shucks. Guess we'll just leave it down there. Oh shoot, I forgot. I didn't get the coin. We also have these coins that are not related to salvaging. We got a Phoenix coin. I didn't get a chance yet to look at your video on YouTube. Sea lions. Let's see, is this an island? This is not. We did not go over any of this map here. If you uncover the map in this game, you get some money too. So you can buy better gear, or kind of better gear. We're gonna look for a castle. This game does look pretty good. And look, there's dolphins! The story is, our character is studying this thing called the Song of Dragons, and it just so happens that the company he's working with, the daughter of one of the co-owners, has a pendant that talks about the Song of Dragons. And we're looking for like some buried treasure or something. This is the most common dolphin in the seas of the Pelago Commonwealth. Short-beaked common dolphins are really friendly, which makes them very popular. You should definitely play with them when you run across them. They'll love it. And if you're really lucky, they might even include you in their games. And then one foggy Christmas night, Santa will come and ask you to lead his sleigh. You know, instead of reindeer games, we got dolphin games. Oh shoot, I don't even think I actually investigated in one yet. So, oh, I guess it's still kind of... Ooh, pink fish. Oh, these are purple queens, I bet. Yep. So yeah, there is a story. I never beat the story. I got sidetracked with looking for fish. There's also side missions. Like, I'm looking for a blue bird right now, when I should be looking for a castle. We pacified a great white shark today, Saturday, I pacified a, what's it called? Tiger shark. Like a pit thing. The last time I played this game, I apparently had 10 hours worth of just me swimming around looking at fish. I really wish there'd be an indicator that lets you know. Like, if you put the cursor over something, it's a different color for fish that you've already discovered. Okay. We can go ashore, maybe that bird will be here. And if not, we'll look for the bird later. So I don't think this game has quests that, disappear. Oh look, a baby California sea lion. Oh, and I got something really cool that I will not be inappropriate with. This is an underwater pen. So I can write with a pen. Look at that. Whoa. Yeah, we can do different colors. Oh, and if you press OK, it automatically puts it there. So now when we swim around, we just have it there. And I will not answer if I'm tempted to draw inappropriate things. I mean, I run into a manatee, or manta ray, I mean. Okay, let's go. We got two other shores that we can check out. if we'll do it since we're already here and I don't want to load in a different area yet. Is that bluebird here? Nope. What I really like is just there isn't very much music when you're swimming, except when you discover places for the most part. Or like when you first load in. And it's just peaceful music. The only thing I wish is that I was able to do a better Jacques Cousteau voice. All the fish then. Yeah, this is Endless Ocean Blue World. I am playing it directly off the Wii. Oh wow, we can walk around the entire thing. Oh, here's a good bird. A Japanese Cormorant. Oh, is this it? Or is that a... Nope, there's a brown boo-boo. It's very relaxing. I'd say it's definitely a good change from Shamu. That's why I picked it. Shamu is disappointing. Okay, I think we have one other shore to check. Let's see, the brown boobies swim underwater. Which, I didn't know that. I always thought the brown boobies were on land. Here we are. Have a nice day, psyched. Have a nice work time, and we'll catch you later. Also, anybody who laughed at me saying brown boobies is totally immature. I'm just talking about a bird. Okay. So we'll check out this surface at the Donut Reef. Okay, we'll check this shoreline, and then we are gonna go back to the Cicero Strait at night. Ah, new animal. Little penguins. And they're young little penguins. And there's a Galapagos marine iguana. But I'm noticing, I don't see that little bird. Okay, fine. Let's go back to the boat. Thank you. Got more of the map done. We still haven't gone to the cliff yet. The drop off. That's fine. Okay. It's the part. We're not even gonna sell the map yet, we don't need to. Oh neat, there's our airplane. Alright, let me summarize what we know so far. The legendary Valka Castle is said to be somewhere in Cicero Strait. However, despite the best efforts of many who have looked, it has never been found. We decided to search for clues instead of the castle, for the castle itself, and we found out that the whirlpools may disappear at night. Whirlpools are most active in southwest Cicero Strait. Triton Village, which was carved on the bracelet that we found, sank in that exact area. Fortunately, we have the equipment needed for night diving, so we should concentrate our search in the southwest of Cicero Strait. That's it, I think. Do you want me to go through that again? No. Please, no. Now, all we need to do is wait for nightfall, and then we start diving. You can advance time by selecting rest while aboard the boat. I guess we actually have to be night diving. Okay, fine. I like how that's just rest. I mean, we know what it really is. What it really is. Is. Adjusting the time of day. Like, this game doesn't actually count your days directly. I mean, maybe indirectly it does, but directly it does not. It doesn't say this is day 6. Okay, night diving. Be safe. What are these? John Dory. Okay. Oh, pillars. That's pretty cool. Yarge? I guess I don't know. Ooh, got some spooky music and stuff. Triton Village Ruins, Cicero Strait. So, these are the Triton Village ruins. They were hidden by the Cicero Undines. Based on historical records, these ruins don't seem to have any direct connection with Valka Castle. But we can't be sure until we looked around for clues. I read that wrong, but I don't care. Cool tail sharks again. Some John Dories. Would it help if I have out my multi-finder? That's too big for a bag. We need a bigger bag. I mean, there's stuff to be had here. Yeah, let's take the small bottle. Okay. Is there a coin? No, but look at that fish. Hey, some young olive flounders. Don't you think they're lovely, huh? You think they might be right-eye flounders? There's a way to tell large-toothed flounders apart from right-eye flounders. Do you know it? Which way do their faces look? It's large-toothed left, right-eye right. Wait, right-tooth-eye and left. Oh, forget it, I'm all confused. Okay. Night swimming sure does look cool. Hey, somebody's here. What? I don't believe it. L&L Diving Service. Oh, it's Gigi. Gaston Gray. What are you doing here? Hey, I thought I told you to call me Gigi. Fancy meeting you guys here of all places in Cicero Strait. Somehow I don't think this is a coincidence. You must be following the same lead. Well, you better stay on your guard, because right around here, what? Oh, look at the time. I'd better be going. Usually shows up right about now. Sorry, I can't stick around. I gotta go. And if you know what's good for you, you'll probably want to get out of here too. Hey, wait. What's the matter down there? Did something happen? Grandpa, there's somebody down here already. And after saying that, he just took off. What was he so afraid of? Oh, look. Sharks. Thanatos. I mean, sharks don't. Whoa, that's an enormous great white. Is that what Gigi was worried about? The man-eating shark, Thanatos? Oh no, he's coming this way. If we don't do something about him, we won't even be able to surface. Can you use the pulsar? Shoot, 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 shoot. Well, where is he? There. I don't believe it. The pulsar has no effect. Yeah, that's a great idea. Let's hide in that well. Well. The shark is so big, he won't get in. Let's do it. Two. Come on. Over here. Run, 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 run. I mean, we're already going in here. We should just explore the well. We should be safe down here. It looks like we're going to be alright. I wonder if there's any chance that shark will just give up and go home. Just to be on the safe side, I'll share my air with you. You know, this isn't really long. You know, isn't this really long and deep for a well? It looks like it goes on forever. This is really strange. It's like an underground passage down here. Wait a minute. What if this well is actually a secret entrance to the legendary Valka castle? Come on, let's go deeper and find out. Oh, and the map isn't... okay. But now we have to be careful, because there are hazards. I remember that much. First, let's make sure we get any coins. What's that? That's a teardrop butterfly fish. And what's this? That's a golden-tailed damsel. That is not what I wanted. See that thing? That's an octopus. See that thing? That's a blue-green promis. And see this thing? I don't know what it is. Coin. A sea slug. Not, no. Orion coin. Bicolor parrotfish. Lepus coin. Lepus. Harlequin sweet lips. Why would you name a fish sweet lips? Yes, we have to go up. Okay. It's like an enormous tower. There are two corridors up here, one to the north and one to the east. Now, I can pretend that the one to the north is not, can I surface? No? Okay. Dive! Look, now you swim down. There you go. Okay, we're gonna take the eastern path first. Collapsed gallery. A line surgeon fish? Let's make sure here. That's right. What do we find? A large barrel. Well, no, I don't want the large barrel. Anything but the large barrel. Interesting this game would be if you played it with a VR headset, because you can do that with some Wii games with some finagling on the PC. Why, I think we might have found the castle. The Castle of Valka. At the Aegean Sea. Look how pretty it looks. Look at this place. It has to be the legendary Valka Castle. Grandpa, we found it. Can you hear me? I can, but just barely. The reception is terrible. But it sounds like you found what you were looking for. Nice work. My dad must have been searching for this castle too. Could he be trying to tell us to find that treasure? The one that Chi-Chi was talking about? Let's look inside the castle and see what we can find. Wait a second, this is your first confined space dive with an overhead environment. You're in a very old structure, so proceed with utmost caution. You have the underwater pin, right? Leave it. Use it to leave a marker in a place it's easy to remember. That way, if you get lost, you should be able to find your way back to that point safely. However, it's primarily a means of underwater communication. Well, anyway, let's test it by leaving a marker here. I'll leave the design up to you. Make it something awesome. Okay. Confused marshmallow is perfect. Look at that. Fish has gathered around your mark. This is called a positive photo axiom? Axism? Some fish are attracted to the glowing fluorescence of the underwater pin. Isn't that fascinating? It's fun to use this pin to attract fish. It's fine. Oh good, singing. I really appreciate the singing game. A grouper and a paired fish, places for coins, and whatever these are. Sunset and Dias. Yes. And a tiny thing over here, a chameleon coin. And what is this? Ah, look at that. A Torita Opus. That small thing there. That I am not going to try to pronounce. Also, I am kind of surprised because I could have sworn that there were some dangers here that we had to worry about. Maybe they are further along for these fishies. Oh! Look! Branch sea slug. I enjoy this music, but I'm pretty sure that YouTube won't when I upload this. Aha, here we go. Stop! There are Luna lionfish here. Their long dorsal and pectoral fins are extremely venomous. It will be incredibly painful if you're stunned by one of them. They won't actively attack you, but they still are very dangerous. It's better to stay away from them. Damselfish? Ooh, look at those tiny rays. Blue-spotted ribbon-tail ray. Luna lionfish. They are bad. Stay away, you lose oxygen. Oh shoot. Okay. Don't panic. You got this. Is that a red grouper? No, it's a cardinal fish. Okay. There's a locked door. The door is locked from the other side. You cannot open it from here. Of course we can't open it from here. Okay, we're gonna go this way. So beautiful. Oh, look at this door. Is the door locked from the other side as well? There's a hole in that door, so I'm small can get there. Am I someone small? I am not. Maybe you need the dolphin with me. Okay, so we're in Valka Castle. We have to watch out for lionfish. Oh, this is a nice looking hallway here. Look at that. The underwater gallery. Yes, check that out, please. Ooh, a jellyfish. This is a mauve stinger. And this is a spotted something. Oh, a clown triggerfish. And a clown wrasse. Do we know what these are? Yeah, we know what those are. And I bet we know that one. Yeah. That's a groper, too. Groper. I'm a grope. And be careful of the groper fish. What's that thing? Is that a slug? No, that is a Berthella orantiaca. Tika? Whatever. Next. A coin, and we've seen these clownfish before. That was a Venus coin. Nice. Harlequin sweet lips. Jelly. A mauve stinger. Looks like it has some bioluminescence or something with it. A sea robin. Okay, here we go. Have to be careful of lionfish. There's one section in here that I remember. Hey, look, over here, there's some kind of weird map. Hear me down there? It sounds like you found something quite unusual. That's a map of the circular Earth, also called Anaximander's map of the world. Oh, Anaxi, something. It's one of the several world maps that the ancient Greeks created. It depicts three large continents on a circular disk surrounded by a single ocean. Imagine what ancient Greeks would think of a modern-day globe. That map may be something from Prince Valka's private collection. Take it.
just take the map. That did not provide any new information for me. A large head hare tail. A red cornet fish. A samurai squirrel fish. Samurai squirrel fish. That almost sounds kind of made up, if you ask me. There's the thing I want. Nothing. Well, this game keeps playing the same song, and I'm okay with that. Ooh, is this a ballroom? This looks like a ballroom. Yes, Mermaid's Ballroom. Okay. We don't want to miss any coins while we're here. Do they just look like the same thing? Yep, they totally look like the same thing. Okay. Can you hear me? It's John Eric. That's a false killer whale. It's bigger than other members of the dolphin family. They get their name from their similarity to orcas, also called killer whales. They're curious and intelligent, and some even appear in shows and aquariums. I think they're absolutely beautiful. Okay, cool. I think whatever, sir. Camera.
Steady.
Look, there is King Lionfish. Wait. I know. We should do this. I suck at drawing with this, but whatever. Nope. Okay. Alright. And there we go. And then we can pull out our camera. And there. We now have a king lionfish. So I'm a mature adult. There's that room. you touch the lionfish, you lose oxygen. I believe I've said that before, but just to reiterate, we're not gonna pet it. Look, now it doesn't look as bad as when I was drawing it, does it? Nope. You know what? That dolphin's small, right? It's locked from the other side. Here, dolphin. Who rests in the king's position will surely enter the royal study. Well, I think that's what it says anyway. Latin's not really my strong suit. The king's position, what's that all about? I know. I think there's something there, but there's a dangerous Luna lionfish in the way. Oh, we could use a tool, huh? Focus on it. That's not gonna be inherent at all, is it? Aha, I got the key anyway. What could this key be for? Can you think of anything? Yeah. We got 4 bars, 3 bars of oxygen. We need to hurry. Use the key. Sounding music. The shelves are covered in the remains of decomposing books. Oh no, this kind of spooky sounded. A Centaurus coin. Okay. Oh no, what's gonna happen. This must be a portrait of Prince Valka. There's something written on the frame. Even after I'm gone, I will watch this door forever to protect my treasure from thieves. Oh, what door could that be with the book that does, that's not decomposing? Golly jeeper, what fish was that? I'm running out of oxygen, buddy. Okay, it's just a cat shark. There's an ornate desk. Yeah, that's fine. Only one volume is still in good condition. Well, pretty sure it's fake. The title is Clavis, which means key in Latin. Check the book. Oh wow, it's a hidden door. What's inside? We've gotta find out, come on. Do you hear that? What's that sound? Is it music? Can't you hear it? What is it? No, the door. Don't tell me this is some kind of trap. It's locked, and I don't think we can open it. Let's try calling Grandpa. Hello, Grandpa. It's no use. The signal isn't getting through. What are we gonna do? We're trapped. Don't panic, you'll use more oxygen if you panic. You're right, we need to calm down. Let's try to find a clue to help us escape. I can't stop thinking about the hidden door that we opened. Three bars left. Any coins? There is. Nice. Lyra coin. We're just finding coins all over the place. Lucanos tablet. Oh, lupus lazuli tablet. It's beautiful. There are what look like characters or designs carved into the surface. It must be preserved so carefully. It's been preserved so carefully. It must be incredibly valuable. I wonder if the owner of Valka Castle created all this just by this tablet. If he did, then this must be a place he regularly... If he did, then this must be a place he visited regularly. And that means there must be some way to reset the trap. Let's go back to the King's Chamber and search again. I don't know, we could close the thing, that might be good. Whoa, shoot. Oh, one thing before we go. There it is. Please be small. Oh, it's a large. Darn. There's another thing here. Ah, it's an ingot. We can't carry that in our bag. Do you want to know how to reset the trap? I think it might be the desk, maybe? Hey, there's a lever under the desk. Let's try it together. We have to do it at the same time, okay. One. Oh. Pulled too soon. Yeah, let's try it again. Oh, pull it when you say pull. One, two, three. Go, go, go! Woohoo! Now we can get out of here. Oh my gosh, that is amazing! Wow! That's a huge North Atlantic right whale. I guess they're here in the Cicero Strait too. That was eerie. I swear that whale was looking straight at us. Grandpa must be starting to worry. Let's get back to the boat. Yes, let's. Can I just pull it up? I can. Sweet. Instead of like, no, sorry, you can't. You're stuck. Okay, we're gonna get more stuff to read. 20 minutes. We got all of that. Oh, nice. We even got a little red dotted line. Thank goodness you're both alright. I was so worried after I lost radio contact with you. How did your search of Valka Castle go? Well, we found this. A lapis lazuli strait. Stand plate. That's odd. Why would something like that be there? Let me take a look at it. How strange. This writing is completely different than what's on the bracelet we found earlier. Recently. I wonder if this is the legendary treasure of Valka Castle. It's what the salvager was looking for, isn't it? Yoo-hoo. You talking about me? Gaston Gray. I'll be Gigi. Yep, how many times do I have to tell you? Please call me Gigi. It sounds so much cooler, you know. Great, Gigi. Good game. What? Good name, you mean. So, what's all the excitement about? Oh, just a little surprise we have for you. You know, legendary Valka Castle and its treasure? We found them before you. For the win. You what? You have got to be joking. Nope, I even have the proof. If you'd like to see it, that's one of the Okanos tablets. Well, that's the only thing you found in Valka Castle. It means the Prince of Valka hadn't gotten hold of it yet. What are you mumbling about? I've just realized that what I'm looking for isn't even here. You know something about this tablet, don't you? Yes, one of a set of tablets left by mysterious ancient people called the... Oceanites? It's a K though, so I don't think it's Oceanites. Okanites? Quite a few have been found around the world, but they're out of place artifacts never fitting into the right time place. They went to all the trouble of carving stuff in precious lapis lazuli, so they must have been trying to tell us something. There's no one alive who can read this alphabet. So, you don't know what it says? Nobody does. And because of that, the only value it has right now is archaeological. It belongs in a museum. What I'm searching for has a lot more real-world value. Something that jingles in the pocket, you might say. You mean like silver and gold coins? Well, let's just say that's my little secret. But anyway, thanks to all of you, I can now cross this place off my list. Hasta la pizza. He doesn't care about anyone but himself, does he? Oh, shoot. What is it now? Our bet. He lost the bet. He didn't find the castle first. He said he'd scrub our boat. But he probably would have done a terrible job anyway. On a more serious note, you saved Oshana again, yet again. Please accept my sincerest thanks. It's already light out. Let's go back and get some sleep. You have earned a new title, Mediterranean Adventurer. Of course we're gonna save, and we're gonna get a water.
New title.
Yep. Back to Nine Ball Island. The discovery in Valka Castle made headlines all over. And LNL Diving Service was suddenly thrown into the limelight. But the mystery still remained unsolved. What did Oceana's father encode information in the... Why did Oceana's father code information in the pendants? Could Oceana's father have been searching for the Okinos tablet that was found in Valka Castle? Right now, the tablet is the only clue. I know we've just returned. There's something I would like to tell you. The news about the discovery of Valka Castle has spread far and wide, and it has made LNL Diving Service a little famous. Because of that, we started to receive requests from all over the world. There are photo requests from people who want photographs. I was about to say photography. Photographs. Place or animal. And guide requests from people who want to be guided around areas like tourists. And these will provide you with not only great diving experience and exposure, but also great rewards. If you want to take a photo request, talk to me. If you want to take a guide request, talk to Oceana. By the way, I've added to my list of guided tours, guided tour locations, Cicero Strait North. That's it. Ask me, Kim, anytime. Okay, first thing, let's talk to Oceana and get some money for our map. We've got one guided dive request. Just let me know when you're ready to take, when you want to take it. Maps, dear. Yes, Cat, I see you. Stop, Cat. Cool. Now I have perfect 480p wallpaper for my computer. Let's call Nancy and see if there's new stuff to buy. That's what we really need to aim for right now. We need new things. Here I am, like a bolt from the blue. What can I do for you? Oh, is there something you want to show me? This is extremely rare find. She can't. So, what do we have written on it? I refuse to believe this. Writing that I, Nancy Young, cannot decipher? Where did you find it? Details. Explain the story so far. I see. So these are the writings of the mysterious ancient Oceanides. Actually, that does ring a bell. I've heard something about this somewhere recently. Of course. Professor Sakura. I'm pretty sure that she was studying the language of the Okies. Professor Sakura? Sakurai? Who's that? She's a genius oceanographer. Well, not just that. She has a degree in biology, mechanical engineering, archaeology. She's pretty much every degree you can get. She just came over from Japan to do a guest lecture at my university. You could say I have connections in high places. What's she doing now? She's working at an aquarium in Japan. I think she's their vet. A vet? Well, it relates to her research on marine life. What an extraordinary person. Well, what should we do? We've got to go to Japan and meet her. Anything else?
Oh.
I've gotten some new stock that I think might strike your fancy. I'm bringing you the latest and greatest dive gear straight from the manufacturers. Need better air management on those deep dives? Buy a better regulator. Pulsar and underwater pin running out just when you need them? No problem. I've got bigger and better batteries and ink cartridges right here. I bet those ink cartridges probably cost an arm and a leg. Take a support tank down with you for even more breaths of precious air. You'll also want a good silencer so you're less obvious to dangerous creatures. And last but not least, take a bigger bag down with you for all those salvage items. As a pro diver, it's up to you to have the latest equipment, so shop away. First, appraise my jug thing. Ah, it's 40p to appraise. Let's see. Actually, this is a neat find. Let's just take a second. Here you go. It was a glass vase. Okay. Buy items. Okay. It increases air by 10%. What's this do? Oh, nice. We can't buy most of this, but that's okay. That's fine. Ooh, military tank. Rescue fence. They're nice looking, I like them. No, don't buy those yet. More tchotchkes for our island too, huh? That's fine, that's fine. I really don't care about decorating my stuff. I really care about selling my map. Looks like this Professor's Vigari is on the top lead for getting this tablet read. And she's working as a vet at a Japanese aquarium. I wonder what she's like. You completed that first map in a flash. I'll collate all the data and put it on sale. Get out there and work on the next map. Should have some sales figure ready by the time you finish the next map, so look forward to it. Make enough from this, I'm going to buy myself one of those sunfish t-shirts. Here's a reward for your good cartography work. And here's a bonus for filling in the whole map. You're doing great, keep it up. Been working like a dogfish. Ha 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 ha. Here, have a new title. Castle Goal. Spare change. Take a look at your titles on the certificate by the table. Now let's go buy more gear. I'm just gonna do it this way. Oh, There was actually someone who wanted to ask you a favor. I was over a deep hole a little while back. Don't ask me how I managed it, but I dropped my scissors. Okay. You cut people's hair underwater. First things first, a big ol' bag. What's this? Buy more oxygen. Did I buy more oxygen, or is it thinking? It's the wrong button on these things, but that's fine. There we go. So we just got our little upgrades here. Good. Don't forget my scissors. So we're gonna go to deep hole first, I guess. Okay. Nice. Time changed, the music has changed. We're not gonna go to the aquarium yet, we're gonna go to here. We gotta help out Nancy. Then we'll go to the aquarium. Dive. Sure. The sun is setting, so we have... That's neat. Deep hole. What kind of hole is it? It's deep. Is there a coin here? No, that's just those dudes. Okay, whatever. Oh. Game could have used the pro controller thing with the plastic controller. It would have worked out just fine. What is that? A banded angelfish. What are these? Stocky and Thias. Okay. Seen those failfish tanks before. Starfish. A sea star.
My bad. It's a sea star.
There's two of these things. Hey, a coin. Cool. We got the Cassiopeia coin. I guess you can't get that little sliver right there, can you?
That's fine.
Oh, I need this thing out, don't I? Looking for. Uh-oh. Mouth of truth. I guess we didn't discover it the first time. Oh. Oh, shoot. Oh, he got me and he got two things of my stuff. These are Pacific white-sided dolphins. Just their uniquely shaped dorsal fins. They're far more prevalent than bottlenose dolphins. The ones in Malago seem to prefer areas with cooler water. They're active and intelligent, so it's definitely worth the effort to befriend one. Here, have some food. Okay, that's nice and all, but I have a mission here. Can you hear me? This is Sean Eric. What do you make of this? The shape is like a little like a screw. It's not seaweed, it's shellfish or sea slug, can you guess? I think this is an egg of a Japanese bullhead shark. The unique shape allows it to secure itself between rocks or in seaweed. Shark eggs can take up to a year to hatch after they've been laid. This egg isn't ready yet. Let's leave it alone for now. That was interesting. Fun fact. Shark eggs take a year, can take up to a year to hatch. I've always wondered, because I haven't looked it up, do sharks spawn like fish, regular fish? Or do they have like some other thing set up? I mean, I'm not gonna go into the whole process. Almost done, and then we'll go inside the great hole, the deep hole. See if we can find some scissors. Because I'm pretty sure we have to use our fancy little multi-sensor here. Okay, where is it? That's not it. Oh shit. That shark is going to be a nuisance. It's okay though. What on earth is that? This is a giant grouper. Thank you. wrong ring.
Yes. We found Nancy's scissors. Deep dome. The Tama Tall. Okay. We don't really care. We got the scissors. And we got a ring. That's all that we were really looking for right now. Nothing there, but look at that. Almost the entire map there. Since my person has no sense of time, we're gonna call Nancy right now, even though it's, you know, sunsetting. There you go, take your scissors. No doubt about it, these are my scissors. You're the best, thank you. Now I can reopen my mobile hairdressing business. Don't look so surprised, I'm really good. Why don't I cut your hair to thank you for finding my scissors? It'll be almost for free. Look at that, now I can change my hairstyle. Oh, I don't have enough what? Pelagos? Are you kidding me? How about you appraise my ring then, huh? Spend the 60p to get how much back? This can't be. This is amazing. How long did it take you to find this? This should just take a second. Here you go. Ah, look at that. A trident ring. That's worth 9,800 halagos. No refunds on getting your haircut. Trident ring, I can't believe you really found it. I know people who'd give anything to get a hold of what you've got. How about this spread all over the world? Elnal's service is getting more and more famous. Your hard work is keeping me busy. Here's a token of my appreciation. A barrel sponge. Thanks a bunch. If you need anything else, just call. I got a sponge for my barrel. No. Oh. See, you have some reef decorations. There's something I'd like to ask you. Speak with you over here. You know about the private reef in the easternmost part of Katana Atoll? Private Reef is a conservation area. The Pelago authorities have entrusted me as the steward of that area. I'd like you to help me if you're willing. It's not difficult work and it's quite fun. I'll explain it to you the next time we're in there. No, I don't want to get roped into that. Inner cabin. I mean, it's probably not going to take too much time to get there to the aquarium.
I wouldn't want to go at midnight.
Located a mere 15 minutes from the nearest train station, this aquarium complex is one of the largest in the world. Its centerpiece is a massive acrylic tank large enough to house whales. You can see everything here, from the very small sea creature to huge marine mammals. Look at all the fish here at the aquarium. I've never seen anything as bare and dark as a newly built aquarium. The guards said Professor Sakurai should be in the Marine Life Annex. You should be able to get to the annex through there. Let's see what we found. Excuse me, we're looking for Professor Sakurai. And you are? My name is Jean-Eric Louvar. Louvier. Of L&L Diving Service. Our colleague, Eric Young. I'm awake, I promise. I'm not tired at all. My colleague, Nancy Young, contacted the professor about our visit. Oh yes, she told me all about you. So, what do you want to know? Well, we're looking for Professor Sakurai. You're speaking to her. I'm Professor Ayako Sakurai. I'm in charge of seeing to animal welfare, selecting species to display, installing equipment, and many other things. What? But you're too young to be a professor. Shanna, please forgive her, Professor. Actually, I'd already heard about you. You're the ones who found Valka Castle in Cicero Strait. I read about it in a journal. It sounded like a great adventure. So, you must be the super diver. I've heard so much about super diver me. You're skilled with high-tech equipment and have no fear of dangerous animals. And your finely honed skills and intuition allows you to get better of famous salvager Gigi. L&L's diving service is super diver torpor. Well, that's what I read in the article. What? When did an article like that get published? Well, well, you don't look too unhappy to hear that. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. You had something to ask me? You explained the story so far to the professor. Elkanos tablet. So that's what you want me to look at. Fascinating. You have my full attention. I should be able to decipher it for you if I can find the time. The ancient script is extremely complex, even for me. Professor, there you are. Oh, Mr. Kiyomoto. Kaimoto. Not Kia. Kaimoto. I didn't think you'd come down here. I was looking everywhere for you. Why do you always have to disappear the second I turn my back? Because she's Batman. Who are these people? What? Asked the professor to decipher an Okanos tablet? Absolutely not. I've already asked the professor to concentrate on other work. Please, Professor, we don't have much time left before we open. What kind of work is it? Oh, it varies. For starters, I've asked the professor to go to the Arctic. I need her to carry out research on the life and habitat of polar bears. If that's all, we can go to the Arctic and place while she deciphers the tablet. You'd go instead of the professor? That's no problem for L&L Diving Service, discoverers of the find of the century. Well, I don't really know. Is that alright with you, Professor? It's not a problem for me. I'm actually much more interested in this tablet, because it's cold in the Arctic. Alright then. Here's what I want you to do. Go to the Arctic, find a polar bear, and observe it as closely as you can. I want to put a polar bear on display here in the aquarium, so I need as much data as you can get. Polar bear. Polar bear is a mammal found across the whole of the Arctic. It lives on the ice and preys on seals and other animals. In order to get out of the water onto the ice, it has to find an ice hole that it can climb out of. The Arctic Ocean is probably deeper than any ocean you've ever dived in. The water temperature is low, and with normal equipment, you'll start to lose body heat immediately. You'll have to move quickly and get to your destination without delay. I hear you've befriended a dolphin. Maybe he can help you out. My name is Ken Kaimoto. I am the curator of this aquarium. I work for a number of aquariums developing new and exciting exhibits. I'm taking care of this one until it opens to the public. Do you have any other questions?
Nope.
Leave the tablet to me. I should have it deciphered before you get back from the Arctic. Have a safe trip. Yes, because going to an ocean where, you know, ice is on the floating on the surface, water. Call Nancy and see if she has any, like, I don't know, long johns for us or something. Let me guess, you need something new. I knew it. What can I do for you? Do you have any, I don't know, keep me warm type of things? It's stylish, but I mean, I don't know if it's gonna do anything for us besides. Oh, we have to play with our dolphin, don't we? Have a good night, last one. Hope you have a good day tomorrow and you're not in pain, man. Do it. Good job, dolphin. Do you have any food I can give you? It's relaxing. I do. Here. Have some fish. Some more. Okay. Point at your partner and do a trick. Here we go. Very good jump. Not your highest, but, you know. It wants a reward. Fine, you spoiled dolphin. Here you go. Sing for me, dolphin. Okay. North coast of Canada, Arctic Ocean. Oh, sure, let's go. Freeze! Gosh. Tigger, you are in the way. The sensor bar cannot see a thing. And I can't read what it says. This drift ice region is said to be home to polar bears. It's amazing. It feels like the entire area is covered with a big carpet of ice. So, what's the plan? Walk over the ice and look for a polar bear? The Arctic ice is getting thinner each year because of the effects of global warming. I suspect walking across the ice might be too dangerous. Would be too dangerous. Yes, I agree. Then I guess we'll have to dive. Here's what we'll do. If we spot a polar bear from the boat, we can swim to the spot. Then go ashore using a hole or a gap in the ice. What about the ice cold water, though? You should be fine with these dry suits I prepared. Blown off for total protection, however, as the water temperature will be sub-zero. Compared to other areas you've dived in, you'll lose energy more quickly and your air usage will increase. What is it? That looks like a polar bear. Some white bear. Really? Wow, that sure didn't take long. Where? I'd say directly northwest of here. That's lucky. There's a large hole in the ice right around here. It also looks like you'll be able to go ashore. I suggest you set off right away. Oh yeah, before I forget, the dolphin you befriended back on Nainbaan, and also any other animals you make friends with, can dive with them. If any of them as your partner. Think of them as your personal animal diving buddies. Huh? Cool, huh? In a tough environment like this, they'll be even more help to you than a human partner. So make sure you take an animal partner along with you. Okay, first we're gonna save. I think this might be our last dive for the night. Yeah, continue. Yeah, I know. We already saved the king picture, so. Fluffy Bottom to the rescue. Yeah, sure. Northwest. Now, that gives me a warm feeling. Doesn't it give you a warm feeling? Look at all the cracks on the ice there. North coast of Canada. Arctic Sea. Arctic Ocean. The Arctic Sea. This is Jean-Eric. How's it looking down there? On your map, I've marked the place where the polar bear was seen. Get lost. Press 1 to bring the map and see where you are. And also, because of the extreme cold of the water here in the Arctic, neither your equipment nor diving level will allow you to reduce the amount of air you use. Your strength is drained by freezing seawater, making it hard to swim. Maybe your dolphin partner can help? Have your dolphin partner help you move around the waters. Yeah, okay. Hold on. Caitlin. Okay. And... Hey, bud. Wait. Get closer to that. I want to see those... A bearded seal. Neat. Fluffy Bottom. Okay, bud. You're gonna be my, swimmer this time. It's Jean-Eric. How are things going? Did I hear you right? The dolphin is helping you? Very clever indeed, making the use of its speed like that. Seems you're still full of surprises. At aquariums, that technique is known as a dolphin ride. While riding, you'll be unable to carry out certain activities, but you'll be able to move freely and at high speed. Utilizing this extra speed should enable you to reach your destination before the cold saps away your strength. Good luck. Okay, so as much as I want to check out these other fish, I'm not going to. We need to head over this way. We've only got so much oxygen that we can use. And regardless of our diving skill or equipment, what? Just a moment. Oh no, a Greenland shark. And it's a big one too, and it looks agitated. Be careful. Greenland sharks resemble great white sharks, but live in much colder waters. They're terrifying beasts capable of swallowing a dolphin or a seal whole. According to legend, they've been known to attack humans too. You haven't got the time to turn back now, so try using the dolphin speed to get past it safely. What? What's going on here? Oh, we got a fancy little cutscene for the area. Ice Mosaic. That's fantastic game. No, 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 no. If my dolphin... Yeah, no, I know, game. We pacify the shark. Come on. Gotta find this polar bear. Who we might be... Yes, here we go. Yes, game, I know. You've invaded the Greenland shark and arrived safely at the ice hole. Nice job. It looks like. Sorry, folks. My ability to read today apparently has been not the best. If you look up, you'll see that you are directly underneath your destination. The water here is a little warmer, so you should be able to swim without the dolphin's help. Aim for the large ice hole directly above you. Make your way up to it and raise your head above the surface. When you're at the surface, press A to lift your head out of the water. Yes, I know. I did this in different places. Managed to reach the area where the polar bears live. You can start your observation our way. It's up to you how to proceed. Carefully study the polar bear's behavior for a while. While doing so, you notice the polar bear is beginning to act strange. It seems it's been looking for something. Perhaps it's getting ready to hunt. Polar bears have a very keen sense of smell. Judging from its actions, I'd say it's digging up a seal's ice hole. Polar bears are carnivorous and feed on seals. The ice hole appears to be abandoned. Looks like today's hunt didn't go very well. The polar bear survey was successful. Looks like you didn't have any trouble. Good work. Feel free to return to the boat whenever you're ready. Yeah. Okay. So, we're gonna do probably the dumbest thing ever. It's a polar bear. You don't just go up to it and hug it, you know? Here, do I have, like, fish for you? Would you should have to give you a ton of these, because you're a polar bear. Oh, can I do this? Oh my gosh. If you ever can see a polar bear in the wild, it's probably best that you stay away from it. You know, because it's a polar bear. Well, we got part of the Arctic. Here, the games give me a good idea how to clear the map. The aurora should be visible in the sky here tonight if you surface. Fine, the part. Where am I? You weren't gone for very long, so I'm not done. Oh. I read your report on the polar bear. It's fascinating, especially the polar bear's hunting techniques. I think it was a smart move to ask L&L Diving Service to do this work, so maybe I can ask you to take on some more work as well. You see, there's a job that I absolutely can't refuse, but I have to get some time off from my curating position to take it. Someone to be a good aquarium curator, they need an unparalleled knowledge of the sea, and above all, a flair for presentation. You're the only ones I can think of who might be able to do this so that I can take some time off. How about it? Would you be interested in acting as a curator for all the exhibits in this aquarium? Sure. Yes, that's what I want to hear. You really are a super diver. Wow, you're almost famous. Okay, let me teach you the basics of curating. Put your wetsuit on and follow me. Oh my gosh, tutorial. This is the main tank, the largest tank in this aquarium. It's made of tempered acrylic and is the centerpiece of the whole building. It's the largest tank in the world, so big that even blue whales can be kept here. You can use the main tank to display all medium to large sea creatures that you've encountered and recorded in your marine encyclopedia. You might want to organize the display from inside the main tank, which is why I asked you to bring along your wetsuit. To enter the main tank, point at it, press A, or you press 1 to place the creatures in the tank from outside. When you're all finished, you can sit back and take it all in on one of the benches, or use the elevator to get to other areas in the aquarium. Taking the elevator located in front of the main tank brings you to the other areas. This is a small world gallery, a display area for smaller animals. You can display creatures found using zoom mode here. These creatures are very sensitive, so we divided them into tanks based on their environments. This makes sense. I mean, this is basically like the Animal Crossing Museum, right? The last area of the aquarium is the Marine Life Annex. It's where you can exhibit any animals you've encountered on land. That was the area I first met you in, remember? You'll need to take the elevator to get there as well. That's the exit for when you want to leave the aquarium. At the end of the tour, feel free to have a look around by yourself. Professor Sakura? Oh yes, of course. You asked her to translate that strange slab that you brought here. Well, why don't you try curating the displays for the... No, I don't have any questions. Just let me drop all my fish in here and move on. Also, some mahi-mahis, and so some blue tangs. If I had some clownfish, I got clown triggerfish, but those aren't the same thing. Oh, this is safe. Luna lionfish, yep. Auto placement works just fine. Confirm. Yes. There, I placed some fish. Are you happy now? Yeah, I'm good. Silly game. I'm on a mission here. I've finished deciphering your Okinos tablet. I must say, the contents are utterly fascinating. It is without a doubt the most intriguing of all the Okinos tablets found so far. Yes. What does it say? The treasure of Pacifica sleeps with the queen behind the bronze door in the abyss. The fissure filled by the circular ocean shows the way to the queen's tomb. Offer your flute to the sun of morning, noon, and night, and the dragon's song will open the gates to the treasure. Does that mean anything to you? You said dragon's song. It's on this tablet as well? If I remember correctly, you said you were researching the Song of Dragons. The phrase Dragon Song appears on many of these so-called Okinos tablets, which are believed to have been created by a mysterious ancient ocean-faring civilization. This is probably the origin of all the legends of the Song of Dragons found throughout the world. Which means that when you unravel the truth behind the Song of Dragons, the treasure of Pacifica will be revealed. It's quite simple, really. What's all this about the treasure of Pacifica? It's something important, right? It will end up to be something like a toilet paper roll, or like a kid's toy, right? I'd be like, yeah, it's a... I know what it is. It's a ball on a string in a cup. It must be something that that group of people left behind. According to the tablet, it appears to be in a tomb of some sort. Some sort sunk in the sea. Is that what Dad wanted to tell us about? No, you must stop this. I won't let you get involved with the Pacifica treasure. Why not? You're right. He must have meant to tell you about this, but your father, Matthias, his obsession with that Pacifica treasure ruined his life. So Dad believes the Pacifica treasure exists? Sadly, yes. And it was the death of him. And then he was such a fool. And you too will meet the same fate if you chase after this cursed legend. Cat, you are in the way of the thing.
Move.
Oh shoot, I picked the wrong one. Santa, please. I want to solve the riddle of the Pacifica treasure. What? I felt it at Valka Castle too. The truth is out there in the sea. I want to keep going until I find the truth. Dad may have been obsessed or whatever, but I'll be fine. It's not like it's the only thing I'm doing. If I don't find any more clues, I'll stop looking. And there's nothing more to say about it. There are no more clues. Are there? Well... You do have one clue.
Really?
What? The legend of the Song of Dragons, the mysterious song that brings bad luck. There are recent reports of the Song of Dragon being heard with increasing frequency at sea. Really? Where? The Weddell Sea, an area of 1.7 million square miles spread between Coastland and the Antarctic Peninsula. The sea is full of icebergs, with special iceberg Eidos SM-16P at its center. Personally, I have a great interest in this Song of Dragons from a purely scientific perspective. Oh yeah, sure. I'd like to participate in your investigation if you don't object. I also want to know the truth. Any objections? Is this a good idea? Well, we can hardly say no. Someone with experience working in the Antarctic surely benefit the company. But remember, you must know when to turn back. Okay. Hey, she's joined us. So much reading. And this isn't even an RPG. I think the thing is, though, is that I'm getting tongue-tied or something. Look at the table. Time to save. Yes, Digger, it is time to save. That's probably gonna warn us that if we turn off, we'll lose our picture, and that's fine. We saved the one we wanted to save. Caught up on a cable here. I want to thank everybody who's come to join, watching the VOD, watching the YouTube version, whatever. Thanks for coming and enjoying this wonderful adventure that we're going on. You can check me out on Twitter. You can also check me out on YouTube. I usually post on Twitter when I'm about to stream or if there's a delay or anything. Tomorrow at 9 Central. Not barring any issues, we will continue our trek to find the truth and have more fun with this. And I hope everybody enjoyed it. I hope you have a good day tomorrow. And apparently I missed the host from last one. Thanks for the host, man. So, that's cool. Take it easy. As always, take care. Bye.